Once upon a time, there was a mighty man upon the earth. He did many, many great things, but his life began like ours as a natural birth. He died on September the 9th, 2008, and Wallace D. Muhammad was his name. The way that he promoted human excellence, things will never be the same. He became the leader of the largest community of Muslims in the Western Hemisphere on February 26, 1975. He taught us to always do the best that we can and to stay away from jive. That if we really trust the Creator, religion becomes alive. And that wrongdoing is worse than being in a beehive. His connection to all life exemplified the word kind. And an added bonus of his teaching was that man means mind. That everyone will stand before the Creator alone, trying to cover their behind. That no one had any choice when they were born with choosing their skin color. That life's just a test for us to learn that every man is our brother. For over 40 years, prior to February 26, 1975, we were taught that the black man is God and that the white man is the devil. It freed a lot of minds to understand that the black man too could become a rebel. He taught that words make people, and that a word is anything that brings a message to the mind. That a loving, merciful Creator could not condemn a whole race of people when they had no choice of the color of their behind. He taught that God only means power and force, and ask if you are black gods, why do you keep getting a divorce? He was invited to counsel with the top leaders from throughout the world about his deep understanding of Torah, Injil, and Quran. This was a miracle because he was the Honorable Elijah Muhammad's son. He traveled the whole world from north and south to east and west, and taught world leaders and the common man to never do less than your best. That it's all of our fault if our world is in a mess. He was a common man, and he was always humble. But if he saw you mistreating the creation of God, he would be ready to rumble. He saw himself as just a common man. Oh, how he could explain God's plan and our great destiny on our American land. Always using our best hand, not bowing down to any man. Yes, yes, I can.
This is Imam Hafiz from Chicago, Imam Farah Khan. Could you please give me a call at the masjid number today sometime? It's area code 312-955-6096. Concerning a speaking engagement, Imam Wardney Muhammad would like for you to represent him at. Thank you. Assalamu alaikum.
Yes! Yes, I can! And I will. My ancestors for 400 years had their blood spilled. And dehumanizing chattel slavery was a bad deal. It was not God's will to have so many innocent people killed. We must ask why. History asks why. Why did so many innocent people die? Even after we were brought to America against our will, we continued to be killed. Imam Wallace D. Muhammad had a very sober mind and gave great insight as to why many Caucasians are not so kind. He taught that any time that a picture is put up that's supposed to be a picture of the Son of God, that for every people that don't look like that picture, you can bet that their life would be very hard. Because believing that you are God really makes you a retard. He taught that if all people want to really be kind, help to remove all images that attempt to portray the divine. He corrected a problem that's been going on in the Muslim community for over 1400 years. A problem that has brought many Muslim women to tears. Corrected a problem of many Muslim communities putting up a wall between Muslim men and Muslim women when it's time to pray. What he taught from God brought about a new day. He said that we must always respect what women say. He taught that the religion of Al-Islam is built on five pillars, and that pillar number five is pilgrimage to the Kaaba in Mecca. He reasoned that if God didn't want your wife to go on Hajj, then he wouldn't let her. He challenged that pillar number five is much more important than all local jive. That God does not want a wall to separate women and man. That God wants us all to have internal self-restraint to not do all that we can. Brother Imam Wallace D. Muhammad, we love you beyond words for helping us to connect with the Creator. You could have done nothing greater. Some say that they thank you for bringing us Quran and Sunnah, but they don't really understand. Quran and Sunnah was already here. You taught us how to accept it as an African-American man.
I have here a paper, and this paper is Tulsa, Oklahoma paper. It's Tulsa, Oklahoma Tribune, and this is Monday, March 18, 1991 issue. And a former follower of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, who was one of the leaders in the days of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, is featured here with leading personalities who are working in Tulsa to give assistance to the homeless people. And he is here, and he's identified as one on this special team to attend the problem, treat the problems of trying to get assistance to the homeless people. This brother's name is Arthur Farrakhan. Arthur Farrakhan. He's well known by many Christian leaders. He participated in interfaith conferences, gatherings, and served right shoulder, worked shoulder to shoulder with Christians, helping the needs of the people, the crying needs of the people in his area and outside of his area. How did that happen, that people who identified as black Muslims, extremists, who wanted to see the end of America and didn't care anything at all about even having friendship or any kind of friendship with white people, how has this happened so suddenly that one of the old followers of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, and also a leader in that time, has this image now in one of the American papers of our American citizens? How has that happened?
You taught that God doesn't put a French head on a Nigerian body, or a Nigerian head on a French body, like us trying to be like everybody. It's just lotty-dotty, like an alcoholic drinking a toddy. With your help, we finally understand that we have become a new man. We have become a new people, and we've stopped drinking ripples. Now we're aiming for the stars to red, white, and blue. And we know that it would be a better America when Barack Hussein Obama gets through. It's a new day, and we're finally able to compete for leadership on America and the world. Marry my girl and get up off the ground, cause I ain't no squirrel. Imam Devi D. Muhammad has made it a better world. A better world. A better world.